Back in the magical land of Paper Mario.
Hey, that's awesome. It's a good game. I still like how you have four save spaces of the same exact thing.
Yeah, one sec. I just gotta make sure it's recording.
It's recording fine.
Okay, yeah. Okay. Just had to check.
Not rescuing you, that's for sure.
Is Peach gonna do anything useful in this game?
I don't know, I guess you'll have to see.
Because she did stuff useful in Super Mario RPG.
I guess you'll see, huh?
Oh, am I gonna be able to get to play as Peach right now? Oh my god! The epicness of Peach playing... It's unprecedented! I feel like there is more games where Peach was actually useful besides, like, maybe Mario Kart and the Mario Sports games.
Photo of Mario. Don't look at that. Yeah, just explore the rest of her room. Why not? She powdered her face.
Oh.
You can go up to the comfy bed, too. It does look comfy.
See, this game tries to confirm that they're a pairing. Because I guess the Paper Mario games actually care that Mario might get laid at one point.
Even though Game Theory said that it's probably Luigi.
Oh yeah. They didn't incorporate Paper Mario in the Game Theory, did they?
No.
Well, that was...
By the way, you're supposed to be looking for a secret passage in this room.
Well, hey, I tried.
Going out the front door worked wonderful. Yeah, it was stupid to go out the front door. Gee, I wonder who made you do that.
The god. I can go into the fire and burn in hell. Oh. Isn't this her own castle? Shouldn't she know if there's a secret trap door in her castle?
I guess so.
Just saying, like, this is a modified version of her own castle. She can't even jump. Oh, Mario 2. That was a game where she was useful, even though that was technically not a proper Mario game.
Yeah, it was all just a dream.
No, it was Doki Doki Panic. Oh yeah, and it was just a dream. No wonder Peach was useful, because it was a dream.
Well, Super Princess Peach, she basically goes through it, and her tears are a weapon. Gee, I wonder whose diary this is. It's not completely obvious.
I feel bad I'm reading Bowser's diary.
I didn't know it was Bowser's diary. I know, so fun.
Oh my god. Yes. I ship it. He's just a big tsundere for Peach. Okay. Oh, Bowser, you big tsundere. Bowser is my favorite tsundere.
It's not not like he doesn't make it obvious that he likes her.
Well, a tsundere is someone who acts like they don't like someone they like. Basically, someone who... And a kudere is someone who acts like they're indifferent to someone they like. Like Batman. Batman to Robin, because he acts like he doesn't give a crap about Batman, about Robin.
Yeah, by the way, his power is fucking useless.
That's alright, I have a friend here who can tell me.
Oh, who?
You!
Oh, me! Yeah, I guess!
The Starbeam. Watch this whole story be a metaphor for something.
Alright, you can switch back to Cooper anytime.
When I feel like it.
Oh, there's a bomb. I think there's a bomb wall somewhere, too. I don't actually know where it is. I don't think it's over here. I think it's on the way back.
Oh, I see. Fair enough. Hmm.
Yeah, save it in all four spaces, somehow.
Whatever. I'm sure I didn't need that. Oh, that was a bomb.
Bomb.
I gotta remember the controls again. Sorry, I forgot the, damn it. I forgot the controls.
Oh god, you're such a massive fail at this game.
Alright, so that's items. That's part, wait.
That's partner switch.
Down. There we go.
She doesn't damage you.
It feels like she would.
But she doesn't. Why would your own partner damage you?
It's just gamer's instinct.
Why would your own partner damage you in this game?
It happens in other games.
No, it doesn't.
Yes, it does.
Ew, Flower Plus. See if you have enough. It should probably be 3 BP.
Seems like badge leveling up badge thing is... I have 0 available.
I mean... You need any? I mean, do you need refund and power bounce?
I like having them.
You can just drop down. You can just drop down.
Ah.
So you're gonna switch that Bombette?
Not right now.
Oh.
I'm not gonna be like you.
Why would you- Oh, you deserve that.
Oh, wow, what an asshole you are.
Oh, you deserve that. Oh. Now, if it were Cooper, you would have been
not
fine.
Not been able to hit him?
Huh?
If it was Cooper, I wouldn't have been able to hit him.
That's not necessarily true.
Yes, it is.
Actually, no, it's not. You could have had him make him dive, and you could have shot Cooper at him.
I see.
Just saying. Yeah, just throwing
fair
it out
enough.
There.
Ouch.
Well, at least you got that part.
Yeah, so I do some things, right?
Sort of.
Crap. I timed that wrong all the time.
I'm never gonna...
I didn't say I wouldn't get screw that one up.
I know.
I said I'd screw the other one. I would never screw the other one up, which I proceeded to screw up like a pretentious little bitch.
Yeah, well, it's okay, honey. I can forgive you, I guess.
Oh.
Very fail.
I failed again.
Hey, at least you'll probably get close call now.
Close call! This one Goomba is gonna be the end of me.
Now, if you manage to hit this with Bombette, right, you can actually kill him in one hit. There you go! I'm so proud of you. Now go heal yourself. Because you're right by your heart.
Am I?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's right over here. Oh, good. That one battle really kicked my ass.
Yeah.
For almost no experience. So, I guess it's time to move on to someplace else.
No, all experience matters.
Fuck.
Oh, this is delightful.
Why?
It's so painful.
Why are you making so much fun of me? I'm just trying to play this game well and not doing well. You don't have to be a little bitch about it. But apparently you do.
Oh gosh. I love you.
This is how she remembers this game. It's like, man, I used to be good at this game, but now I'm watching.
No, I'm actually still very good at this game.
I know. And it's like, no, and then I'm watching this, and it reminds me, man, I'm a lot better than I thought I was watching this asshole play this game.
I would never think like that. Jeez. That's way too harsh, man. Even for me. I would never, ever, ever, ever say something like that to you. Even though I am better.
I feared as much. Alright, nope. No more battles because we gotta go to Dry. Oh crap. Ow, my toe.
You know, Cooper could kill all of them in one hit.
Refresh. Recover HP and FP.
I'm thinking of somebody else. Yeah, you can actually.
That sounds very useful.
You know what I'm thinking of? I'm thinking a 1,000-year door. The first crystal star you get is basically just stops enemies.
Where is my star energy located?
I'll show you. As soon as you get this. Okay. It's right there. So you used all of it. So each attack you do with her and with him should... Actually, star point. I actually forgot how it works. It either works you... Oh! Go up. You can... maybe appeal? Go up to strategies just real quick. No, okay. Go down. Okay, yeah. And then focus. That'll charge your star energy. But you charge star energy after each turn. I'm used to 1,000-year door.
Well, that's good. That means I can use abilities more often now. So I get that refresh ability.
That was very awesome that you managed to jump on a spike Goomba, though.
Very good.
Very good. Very good, man. All right. You can go recover your health, actually, by this guy.
Give me health. Yeah, I guess I don't need it, though.
But you're missing one health.
Stop being OCD.
I'm not OCD. You're just missing health. There's one health there that you missed.
I didn't mean to get into a battle. Oopsie.
Yeah, you did.
No, I didn't.
Yes, you did.
I guess there's no equipment besides badges in this game, right?
Right.
So I'm always going to be doing one damage or something? Until I get badges that level that up. That increases my attack power.
Yeah. And I mean, you'll get badge abilities, yeah. Yes, get it. Yeah, much better.
Wow.
I actually feel a lot better now. It was bothering me.
Oh, yeah, there's the... Off you go. Okay, finally. Alright. Man, it takes a while to get back to town, huh?
Not really. I mean, it took a... you're gonna be stuck in the dry desert for a while. Fuck this dude. This guy gets stronger each time. It sucks.
Oh, well, he sure showed me. Oh. Mario trip.
I don't know. Alright. I don't actually know if a bomb will be useful on him. I wouldn't waste your FP while he's like that.
Ow. So much damage.
Oh, good, you got it, honey.
I know.
I'm so proud of you.
I will show this little kid that I can mean business. Mario, the defeater of little kids.
Ugh. What a dick Mario is.
I just like her, because obviously she's the best to have against bosses, because... And Koops is the best to have against normal.
Cooper.
Cooper is the best to have against normal.
Jump doesn't work on him.
Against normal enemies. Is what I gather so far. At least at
I don't
this,
know. I mean, I...
At least at this current moment in time.
I mean, there's nothing... I love Bombette. I just like Cooper more.
Well, yes, I get that. I'm just saying, because she does more damage on against an individual enemy, while Cooper can hit multiple enemies. And Goombario is useful if you just need to know how to beat the boss at all.
And health-wise. Hey, look, it's Twinkle. Twinka.
Hi, Twinkly.
Twink. His name's Twink.
Hoi.
I'm Timmy. Oh, by the way, you do have a storage unit in at the item store, and I like how Bombette closes the door.
And I go.
But don't worry about that. You should try to find Tasty's house if you can actually get her. All right, so you're probably gonna want to go south. Or do you want to check the post office for letters?
I want to check the post office.
Might also be a good idea to check Luigi after each chapter, too. Hi, honey. Missed you.
Oh, he stays in my team now. I'll just keep him in here because it'll make you happy.
Yeah.
I like Koopa Troopa's,
Cooper? Yeah. I don't know when he actually can level up your party members. I don't think yet. Oh, that bulletin board on the back, I think, changes each time, and the front changes.
Desert.
Well, I won't tell you where it is, but you should explore the... Oh god, I do love the badge shop, but it can be overpriced at the beginning. Let's see. Defense down pound, that's good. First attack is good, and what's that one? Speedy spin.
I'll get speedy spin.
You gotta equip it, remember?
I will take you off refund and put in speedy spin. Does that really make it faster?
Yeah, it is. It's faster.
Oh, that's cool.
Go in there.
In here.
Mm-hmm. whenever I talk to her. This was my favorite part of the game, by the way. It was so fun. Yes. Now you're gonna wanna give her the Koopa leaf because you're gonna make tea out of it.
Why do you like this part?
Because it's fun to see the different stuff you can make. And it restores more. I don't know if you could also make fried shroom with a mushroom. And then you could also make honey syrup. One of those I think turns into a dizzy dial, but I can't remember.
I like
remember.
How you just gave it to her and it basically just upgrades the item.
Mm-hmm.
And
I think, I don't know which one turns into a dizzy dial, but I know one syrup does. I gotta go get my cat. But I knew mushrooms, fried shroom. And then, one cool thing is when you go into the toy box, you get something called cake mix, and she makes you cake! And then you could also make spaghetti. If you get two Wacka's bumps, oh, talk to that guy.
Hi. Wow. Hi. I like flowers. Mario is
those are important. You're gonna need to find guys that look like them because it'll unlock a world.
This town is big.
Mm-hmm. Oh, I loved this part. Now smash it open. Got a regular little oink. Go talk to him. It's just fun. You don't go in there. Don't scare him off.
Oh. You can actually jump in there and it'll scare them off.
Mm-hmm.
I'll do one more.
Yeah, just explore the town before going to the dry desert. It's gonna be a while anyway.
I have to figure out where.
You got a polka dot one!
I guess it's just there to get for your own catharsis. Just there to appreciate pigs. They don't do anything, but they're there. But if I load up with too many supplies, I can't pick up any items.
Yeah, don't go on the train yet. That'll take you to the dry desert. There's still other things to do.
Other things to do, okay.
Just to explore. I just like seeing you explore.
Okay, fair enough. Let's see, is there anything over here?
Mm-mm.
Anything over there?
That's going towards dry desert.
Oh, that way?
Mm-hmm.
Do I have to get on the train to go there?
Yep.
Yes. So you want me to go back up here first?
Just to look around. I wonder what's over there.
Or go over here first. What the hell? Okay. Oh, is this a gambling arena? Wow, this is right for Mario RPG, I think.
Yeah, it's in Thousand Year Door as well, too.
A tribute. I wonder why they thought. You know what? Friggin' Super Mario RPG made it. Needs all the characters to be made out of paper next time.
You can also
I guess to give it a more unique aesthetic, a more stylized look that separates it from just Mario.
You might want to actually try. Oh, wait, I don't actually. Yeah, go in.
Okie dokie. What's over here? Man, this town is huge!
Cheap Ripo.
I bet it's because of, and there's, it's not even the only town in the game is the thing.
No. No.
There you go.
Yeah, but, you have an inventory, I think. Yeah. Or, oh, that's Thousand Year Door, never mind. Heart.
It's two lesbians.
You know, I never noticed that when I was a kid.
It's two lesbians.
That's you can see their sisters.
I guess so. Everyone looks the same. I'm pretty sure that's just supposed to be some lesbians. Maybe not, though. See, Paper Mario was progress when it was made. It was ahead of its time. And
this isn't important right now, but you'll be, like you'll be able to go here later.
I started reading another manga recently that I'll do another.
That one about the three? Okay.
The one about the what?
The manga artist person?
Yeah, the one about the. It didn't sound too interesting from the summary because it was an autobiography of a manga artist. And obviously, I can't judge it too early because I'm only like 7 chapters in out of like 34. You know, and there's plenty of time for it to fall apart, but so far it's very, very enjoyable. Man, this town is big. This is like the biggest starting town I've seen in a long ass time.
Roadport's pretty big too.
Yeah, it was. This town is huge. Maybe I should just go to dry desert now.
Yeah, I mean, you can by all means. Yeah. I just wanted, Tasty's kind of the most important thing to know where it is because you can upgrade stuff. I will tell you that if you get 2 Wacka's bumps from the dry desert from the Wacka, even though it'll make you feel like shit for doing it, because the Wacka's super cute, and you hit him on the head like an asshole. Mm-hmm. Oh, you didn't go that way.
What way?
Into the...
That way?
No. That's not there. Go back. Go down. In there.
Mm-hmm. Very private.
This will be important when you have to, save.
I do love how fast it saves. For how old it is, it's still... Although old games used to save fast, and then disc came, and it's, look. That's the worst thing about PlayStation games, is that they loaded like ass. I'm not supposed to be here, am I?
No, you can. If you can access it, then you're able to do certain parts of the sewer level.
Well, look how much health this guy has.
Yeah, it has about 8 or so. You could do a quick level up while you're down here, though.
But yeah, that. If it keeps it up, I think it'll be the best manga I've read in, like, 2 years.
No.
I haven't really read any manga in the last 2 years that have particularly, like, impressed me, unfortunately.
Well, didn't you finish Ayasumi Poon Poon in the last few years?
2 years? No. I read that when it was... I read that... I don't think that was in a 2-year time frame. I'm pretty sure that was... I think that was 2000.
Oh, don't break that last don't break that last block. Because the spiked guy is just as hard, and he's right up there. Don't break that one.
Okie dokie. He just says blooper. That's what you are, man.
You could probably power bounce him for a while, and it might be a good idea to switch out.
Fail.
Yeah.
Can Bombette even hit him?
She should be able to. Unfortunately, you might actually need Paracarry for this.
Hey. I got him 3 times for a change.
Oh, Goombario can hit him.
Oh, hey, Goombario.
He could probably also tell you how much HP he has, too. You could basically kill him like this.
Oh, this move's unfair.
I know. That's why it's awesome.
Wow. A 30. They seem. Well, at least Nintendo's self-aware.
You almost got him.
No way to skip this, huh?
Nope.
Whatever. It's fine, it doesn't occur that often. You're alright, Surame.
Just fucking use power bounce.
Ow!
I love his eyes! Kill him with Goombario now.
Nah, this won't kill him.
Yeah, well, you could. Well, it would have if you had hit it.
Well, I suck. I'm sorry. You're just dead.
Yeah.
Can you not miss in this game?
No, you can. Well, oh wait. I don't know. You can't, no, unless you're paralyzed or something. If you upgrade your badge power, you can upgrade your FP too. All right, there's a treasure chest over there or something. There you go. You don't need anything. Oop. You didn't even need to use that.
Whatever, frees up some space. I didn't know my, oh, because I leveled up, okay. Huh. Shrink Stomp, is that a special move?
Yeah. It makes enemies tiny.
Oh, it's a special move, okay. I thought it would be a passive and added to my normal jump. That would make it cooler.
Yeah.
Because a lot of abilities in games, that's the problem with a lot of abilities in games, is you get a lot of abilities in certain games, but a lot of them are useless. Mm-hmm. Which is why, even though people might like play a game like Lunar and complain about the lack of abilities, I'm like, well, it does put the bare minimum of abilities, yes, but almost all of the abilities are usually useful to an extent. Unlike Dragon Quest, where most of the abilities you get are worthless, which kind of stinks, but.
Well,
good thing I went in there.
Yep. Oh, it's those stupid sisters that follow you everywhere. Alright, you can go to Dry Dry Desert now.
I have to figure out which.
If you didn't guess, you have to use Bombette. And you thought she'd hurt you.
Alright, going off to Dry Dry Desert.
Finally.
Yeah, only
If somebody wanted to explore.
Yeah, me. You. Off we go.
Oh, that was one of my favorite things about Paper Mario.
What?
Exploring.
Yeah.
Because there's so much you can find.
I feel,
and make sure you get a lemon and a lime for tasty.
I feel like it's been a while since I played an RPG with actually an expansive starting town. I mean, I guess Persona 5 will also fix that, but Persona 5, that will also be the only town. It's like, I'm not used to playing RPGs with towns anymore. It's like, kind of weird. Most RPGs just don't seem to do that anymore.
And fuck this boss.
I can't really say anything because my favorite RPG ever only has one town.
Chrono Trigger?
No, The World Ends With You.
Oh, okay.
It's an action RPG. I know people don't, but it is definitely an RPG all the way. I just love its battle system so much. And I love the pacing of the story, and I love the story, so. Is it a perfect story? No, but I love it. Alright, okay.
Alright. Look at all the stuff you can do here.
Hey, Sir May.
It'll make you feel like extra shit for whacking him on the head, but he has the best healing item in the game. It heals for 25 HP.
I don't need anything like that. I need a better hammer.
Mm-hmm. Paracarry!
I gotta find the letter, okay.
Mm-hmm.
Look at those water graphics. It looks like just like a sheet. Just a thin.
It is supposed to be paper.
Ah, yeah. Touche. Well, I don't think the background graphics are supposed to be paper. I mean, I think it's just characters, right?
No.
Because, like, it's not like. Well, maybe you're right. Ooh. Classy Mario. It's those little things that make the characters have more personality. What?
Sir May. Those poor groundhogs.
They're moles.
Poor groundhog moles.
They're not groundhogs at all, they're moles.
Poor ground creature. Poor Sandshrew.
Sandshrew. Yeah, I guess you could say it's Sandshrew.
Sleepy sheep! You know, you could actually just beat the game with Power Bounce if you wanted.
Yeah, you know, Power Bounce is based on Super Jump in, Mario RPG. You actually got an ability called Ultra Jump later on, but it wasn't as good.
This is ridiculous.
What's ridiculous?
Well, I'll check in a second. Never mind.
You had two cats on your lap?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think Pi's more relaxed because we got her that Seresto collar.
Seresto
collar.
Yeah, she probably likes not having fleas on her.
Yeah.
Sarame!
I should sell that.
Well, you can use it. It works on minor enemies. You hit the Wacka! Okay, take it.
Wait.
No. Seriously, take it. You'll need that later. You can store that and make and take.
Can I talk to him again?
Yeah. Well, go. You gotta leave the screen for him to come back.
I feel bad. I didn't
mean
to.
Yeah, it's the best healing item in the game, but you feel bad hitting him.
I feel bad. I feel bad. I'm sorry. It was like...
You're such a dick.
It was like a reflex. I saw it and it was just like...
Isn't he cute?
Well... I see.
See, if he...
That is a good moral choice system. That's like the best use of moral choice I've seen in games in a while. You don't have to...
Besides Undertale.
Yes, I know. Undertale has the best moral choice system, but...
Oh, and those rocks up there, don't engage them unless you have combat.
I deserve shit for that. The game should punish me for that, because I feel... Actually, it doesn't even need to be, because I just feel like shit. My day is ruined. I hit Wacka, and he was just a nice little mole guy.
Yeah, super cute.
I'm such an asshole. I feel bad.
You're such a terrible person.
I'm an asshole.
You really are.
I like
How
that.
Could you?
I like that that's in the game, though. I'm liking this game more and more. Watch this be my favorite game of this year.
Undertale was your favorite game.
No, Undertale I beat last year, didn't I?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, last year. Yeah, Undertale was my favorite game last year. By far, but it was basically everyone's favorite game last year.
Oh, yeah,
except
easily.
For the people who didn't play it. Or, actually, the website I was watching, RPG Gamer, they did their game of the year, and they didn't even nominate it in the top three, even though the reviewer who reviewed it gave it a 5 out of... That was the only game that gave a 5 out of 5 that year. I think they were being a little stubborn. But they rated games where there was a lot more text in them, like Trails in the Sky Part 2. And I'm sure Trails in the Sky Part 2 is awesome, because I haven't played it, but... I think Undertale really deserves it. I think they were being a little stubborn.
I don't think Rocket League should have beat Undertale either, though.
Oh, at that Game Awards thing? Oh, yeah. That was stupid. That was them being... But, I mean, everyone's entitled to their opinion, but I feel like... Since Undertale didn't win, like, anything, I think that's a little... Shows how... Non-seriously, you can take those awards. It's like they didn't even want to They didn't want to consider it because it's so low budget looking, I feel. And I think they would get embarrassed and people wouldn't take they thought that people wouldn't take them seriously just because of Undertale's fans, because, you know, people say that the fan base, you know, is the worst fan base ever. And
no,
I'm like,
Steven Universe's fan base is the worst fan base ever.
No, I don't like even saying that because, you know...
I mean, everybody has their fan base, but the fact that they, like, that they criticize... But no, they criticize... Like, the fan base fucking criticizes artists who decide they wanted to pick the characters differently. And then they almost drove that girl to suicide and shit.
Well, that sucks. But that's a lot of fan bases. That's just passionate fans who get their passion out of control. That's just a thing. That's not... That's just bad people. That has nothing to do with Steven Universe as a show or a concept. It has to do with...
Oh, by the way, that's the letter.
Yes, I imagine... Actually, I kind of forgot about that letter. I was just kind of...
Well, you kind of need it to get Paracarry.
I see.
He's kind of going to matter.
Yeah, I'm sure he'll have a nice nifty ability to help. Ouch. I'll keep it for now. Yeah, I don't think fan bases in themselves are bad. I mean, every fan base is... When a group as a collection gets together, they usually just get crazy. A little crazy. That's all that happens. Oh, yeah, that's right. Get out of here, Koopa. I'll keep you out here for a little while.
Ah.
Alright, so time to go to Paracarry.
I used to call him Paracarry.
Ow.
When I was younger.
I can see why.
I just thought it sounded better, but...
It sounds like a name as well. I just recently looked up how to pronounce all the Chrono Trigger names by looking at the kana.
How do you actually pronounce them?
Well, obviously Chrono is Chrono. That one's obvious. Because that's...
Are you sure it's not Chrono?
No, it's Chrono.
You just passed him.
I'm getting this. I'm gonna get Paracarry and then I'll...
Get your ass off of the desk! Good job.
Oh. Okay. Wish I knew that beforehand. Oh, well.
Hey, then, well, I feel like there might be one around there, but I'm not too sure, so don't correct me.
You know,
like, there was actually, I feel like there's actually one in the area Paracarry is at. But like I said, I don't remember actually the location of them.
Well, I could go further in the screen, so whatever.
Surame, stop.
So anyway, the names are obviously Chrono's the one that, and Chrono, Robo, and Frog, and Magus. They don't need any clarification. Well, Magus isn't even called Magus in Japanese. He's called Maol, which just means.
That's like, mean like devil or something?
No, it just means it's what you call, it's like a typical cheesy fantasy name. It means demon king, literally. But it's basically what you call the lord of, it's like what you call the final boss of like a Dragon Quest game or of a fantasy adventure. It just means the lord of all the bad things happening in the world, you know?
The main villain of G-Sengen Amal is called Mao.
Yeah, exactly. It's just a typical generic fantasy term. For the last boss, the ruler of all the minions. He's called the Maul, and his real name, Janice. His real name, Janice, is called, he's called Jackie in Japanese instead of Janice. I'm sure they changed that because they think it didn't sound right for him at his appearance. Marl is Marl, and as a kid, I pronounced it Marley, but it is just Marl. It is Luca. I always pronounced it Lusa as a kid. It is Luca, though.
Don't fight those. No, I'm serious. You won't be able to really damage them.
Okay.
Like, you can hit them with Bombette, and that's about it.
Ouch. Ouch.
Yeah, I mean, you're gonna need Bombette for that. Because I mean, the hammers may damage. You're gonna need Bombette.
Okie dokie.
Because she has bombs.
Ouch.
So switch her first. No, you mean you're gonna wanna have her go first.
I have to figure out which button's the Z button, actually. There we go. Robo is still Robo. Frog is Kairu in Japanese, which just means frog, so same difference. Is that all the party members? Oh, and it's Ayla, not... I'm pretty sure it's Ayla. Yeah, it's Ayla. It's Ayla, but it's Ayla.
Oh, see, there's another flower, but you can't get him until you get Paracarry.
Yeah, just checking around here. This might as well. Anything over here? Oh, that's how he got here. Oh. Star thing.
Star piece. Oh, by the way, you can sneak up on those by throwing Bombette at them.
Oh, cool. Did I come from down here?
Yeah.
So I didn't come from up there.
Right.
Okay, so I will go up there. That's the thing about RPGs is when you're fighting, random battles, sometimes you kind of forget what you were even doing because you were, like, focusing on the battles instead. It's like, huh, what was I doing again?
Yep, I totally get you, man.
Oh, it's just a slide. I don't need that then. Although, and this is why RPGs with random battles get you really confused, and you'll be like, what the hell was I doing again? And that's why random battles can suck. Random battles work on specific types of RPGs.
You can't.
Oh, I failed. But hey, I got a letter.
You just got a letter.
Hey, guess what? Oh, yeah, I showed you who's boss.
Actually, there's another way to beat him, too.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm. Go to your items. Use Thunderbolt.
That's useless, though. I don't need to use something. I'll just... For anyway... I'll just refresh. Why not? I could use some FP anyway. Got one more letter to go. Ow. The only bad thing about her ability is I hate button mashing. That's probably why you preferred Cooper over her. Button mashing stinks.
Well, the other fun one to use is Lady Bo when you get her.
Lady Bo.
Yep, Lady Bo. So unfortunately, you can't go any further that way until you get Paracarry. So the letter is somewhere around there. Well, not on the screen, but you know what I mean.
Yep. Oh well. Guess I just missed it.
Back on the very first screen.
Probably. That'd be funny. Well, we'll just check around.
Actually, go back.
Is it on that slide?
It might be. Go back to that slide.
Yeah, I thought as much. But yeah, in RPGs where you have to do a lot of puzzle solving, it's best not to have random battles or...
Do you consider this to be random battles?
This is not random battles at all. There's nothing random about it.
That's probably why you like it a lot too.
See, I think I might have explained this before in our Zestaria playthrough. Do you think I have?
I don't... Yeah, probably.
Okay.
We talked about a lot of things during the Zestaria playthrough.
Yeah, I kind of forgot what we even talked about. I mean, I remember some things. I'm trying not to repeat what I've said, but yeah.
No, but I get it.
They worked okay in Seikoden because they work okay in games where battles are very, very fast. That's one thing where random battles do work, is if the battles are very, very fast, like a Final Fantasy game.
Alright, go that way.
Oh, there it is. There we go. How do I get up there?
Probably that way.
Oh.
Very good.
Ouch. The pain.
You have no one to blame but yourself for that one.
I mean, I like this game because I like that abilities are, you're using them, but you can't just spam them recklessly. But you also, you have to somewhat be choosy with them. But you still get to use them because you have abilities that can recover your FP. So that's nice. So I think from a gameplay-wise, this game is much better oriented than Super Mario RPG was. It has an easier to understand battle system because it keeps the numbers small. Because a lot of RPGs, they do the number thing where numbers get so big, and that's stupid. Because, like Final Fantasy, the max damage is 9,999 or whatever, right? And that's stupid because, and I shouldn't have even gotten in this battle, so let's run away.
Per se. You're gonna lose some coins, but you can.
That's okay. Okay, never mind. I got it.
Alright, well, just use your fire flower.
Do I have a fire flower?
You can use the power block if you don't have it. Or you can use that, that's fine. And just have Bombette kill the other one.
Just I'm running out of FP here. I mean, I don't like it when RPGs,
Well, there you go. Ask and you shall receive.
I don't like RPGs where... Isn't it on the other hill?
It is, but there's also some crap here that you can get.
Oop, I didn't mean to do that.
Well, it took you to the letter anyway.
Oh, did it?
Yeah.
Ah, okay, cool. Letter to Colorado. Let's see, is there anything else over here?
There is. Go in there, and then go to the left all the way.
Huh. Damage done. If you do action commands, decrease Mario's damage by one. That sounds useful.
Yeah.
Let's go to the badges. Okay.
It's three.
Three, so I need. Yeah, I don't think hammer throw is useful. And friggin'. No, I'm not really using speedy spin for now, so it's just a damage dodge. This is an RPG, so let's play it like an RPG. Oh! Ouch! No! Well, time to focus. In this area, you must have had to use Bombette, though, right?
I did.
You said you used Cooper the whole game. I'm like, there's gotta be some
area. Oh, no, I used Cooper for most of the game. I very rarely used my other party members.
I guess I'm gonna need Cara Perry to get over there.
Yeah.
Alright. Cool. But yeah, games like Lunar and Dragon Quest, where they keep the damage down low, and no character can ever reach the cap max damage, that's better, because then you know then the characters who are strong remain strong the whole game. It's kind of stupid when Cloud, Barret, and Tifa do the exact same amount of damage at the end of the game.
Yeah.
It makes the characters less unique. I don't like that every character is basically the same at the end of every Final Fantasy, for the most part, or outside of, like, subtle differences. The differences should not be subtle. Like, every character should be playing a drastically different role. It helps keep them unique. It helps make the player like them more for their individual roles, too.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. Oh my god, this guy's confident.
And that's another side quest you get to do. Cool. You get to deliver letters to people that you find. He's actually, depending on which move you use, he's kind of hard to use in battle.
Fair enough.
Oh, look at that.
Yes, look at that indeed. Okay. Onward we go.
Yeah, and you can go pick up stuff. You can go pick up some stuff that had, what are you doing? Oh.
I was trying to do this. I should set this to a different button or something.
I can't believe you hit the Wacka.
That's cool. That's why in terms of gameplay.
Oh, by the way, his name is Whack-a-Mole.
That's why in terms of gameplay, games like
See, Paracarry can take you over to
yeah.
Get that thing.
Games like games like Lunar age better than FF7 and FF10 because Quake Hammer Badge.
Could probably help you against Clefs.
Let's see, Quake Hammer. Let's see, do a Quake Hammer. What the hell does that mean?
It means you hit the... I think you hit the ground and it hurts them from the ground, but I never used it.
What's the point of it?
Well, instead of hitting them with your hammer, I guess if you hit the ground, it causes a quake.
Okay.
Maybe.
Might knock them over or something.
Okay. Probably. You can drop down from there.
Right. go.
Yeah, you just need to collect all them.
Now, what's he doing? Where do I plant these?
I'll show you. It's not. It's in Mushroom Town, or what is it called initially? Mushroom Town, is that what it's called?
I probably was like Toadstool something, but I'm sure it's in that. We'll just call it the Starting Town. You almost didn't make it. Hi, you're probably a boss. Yeah, I figured. Foreshadowing!
Are you not gonna fight him?
Oh. It's really that easy?
Yeah.
Can I fight him?
You can fight him if you pick Princess Peach or Mario.
Did I screw it up?
No.
How do I fight him?
Well, each time you cross the bridge, I don't know if he might actually stop you that. Yeah, if you leave the screen and cross the bridge, he'll stop you.
Okay.
Do you want to fight him?
Sure, why not? Might as well get some gameplay. I like how it's that simple.
Yeah.
That's funny.
I'm surprised you picked it first. I thought you were gonna... Peach is the funnier option, in my opinion.
I just thought it would be funnier. I thought it would be funny to pick Luigi. Okay, let's try Princess Peach. Don't want to avoid gameplay.
Sure. I get it. Good thing you have Paracarry. You'd have to use Goombario for this fight otherwise.
Well, you got fooled by me being Luigi, so yes.
That's such a waste.
Fail.
Okay. Nice.
I didn't really get it. I see. Ah.
Yeah.
Well, that was a waste.
You want me to do this fight?
Ouch! Nah, I'm okay.
Okay. You do have a pal block.
Oh, okay. Ouch. Might as well use it. I don't really get how to use this ability.
Oh, yeah.
Press and release it. Oh, okay. There we go. That's fun. Mm-hmm. That is a crap kill. Wow, really? How fast would you have to press that to get it?
Pretty darn fast.
That's ridiculous. Oh. I got away.
Nice.
How did I get away?
Because you got in the safety zone?
Press A right before landing. Ow. Fail. One!
You might want to use a healing item.
You know what? Why not? That's what they are for! To use! This game is gonna hurt me! It's gonna hurt my elbows and my wrist!
Sure you don't want me to do this part? Oh, I was so, you're so lucky that you used that, because you would have died that move, that turn.
No, I wouldn't have.
Yeah, you would have.
I had 5 HP.
No, I'm saying before you had 4 HP.
I had 5 HP, didn't
no,
I?
No, you had 4.
Oh, it's hard to time. Haha, you missed. You sure have a lot of health, guy. But this is trivial. Mario and Luigi enemies can take forever. Oh god, I suck at timing that.
Oh, you made it.
Ooh.
Is your hand getting tired?
A little bit.
Yeah, there you go.
Ooh, and plus I need the XP. That's the other reason why I needed to fight the boss. Off he goes. I guess I should feel kind of bad. It's not like we had to fight. I could have taken the peaceful solution, but here I am, being
a genocide route.
A genocide route.
Look at you. You hit Wacka.
I know. I'm an asshole.
Yeah. And there's stuff you can go back for because there's stuff in Mount Rugged that you can get while you have Paracarry. Oh, and the easiest way to go through the dry desert. Start on one screen and yeah, because there's a lot of shit to find in here. So you'll want to talk to him. Important to explore this desert because there's an oasis. You can get a lemon and a lime, and you can actually cook it to some tasty. You can cook it into something better.
Mm.
So the easiest way to explore this desert, how I find it, just if you want to go down and explore, just go down one screen and then go east all the way. You can do that, kind of like go all the way down and go east, and then kind of do the same thing until. Oh, and watch out for them.
They're gonna steal my money.
Yeah, they will. So I would use the POW block on them. Because they have a lot of HP.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Actually, I know how you can stop them. Use the sleepy sheep.
All enemies. What? Wow.
Alright.
For 3 turns?
Yeah, I'll just have Bombette hit the one that wasn't asleep or he'd get away.
Barely any XP either.
Yeah, that's why it's just best to run away from them.
Yeah, I can see why.
forgot about them. I was just used to the cactus.
They drop a lot of money. Well, not really, but... Oh, God.
Oh, yeah, and they're fast, too.
But they only want to run in one line, a straight line. So they're not so bad. Let's see. Whack!
Yeah, you can't. There's nothing in the rocks.
Can't blow them up.
Oh, and watch out for them. Because yeah. What they'll do, they'll whirlwind you to some different area of the desert.
Oh, so they're like the whirlwind from Mario 3.
Yeah, and you get lost.
Hmm. Desert areas in games will always bring back nightmares of Breath of Fire 3's desert journey, which is like a real, it's almost like really going on a journey in a desert. It's so unspeakably...
Oh, these enemies are fine, just not the...
Fair enough. I'll take your word for that.
Yeah. Just kill the thief first.
I can't.
Yeah, you can.
How?
Well, yeah. You could have actually jumped on him.
Oh, I get it.
You can use Power Stomp on him to stop him.
Oh, so that's the advantage of jump. He's dead.
Yep.
You're dead.
You might want to use Cooper. Cooper is the only one who can hit them. Because Paracarry would get hurt too. Just use your POW block, or you can do that.
You're dead, son!
You might actually die, babe.
Oh no! Oh shit! I'm dead! Oh!
Holy shit!
Oh, I didn't realize.
Use your POW block.
Wait, do I have any HP?
Oh, actually, Super Shroom.
That was foolish of me. I was hoping that he would knock them down, but I guess he can't do that.
Mm-mm.
I was not paying attention to my health. Oh, that was close as hell. I was like, that's immersion for you. When you like fear death, you're like, no, I might lose progress.
Watch out.
Aha, I know your ways, little man.
Don't break that gold box yet. Yep. That's important for the thieves, so Sleepy Sheep and the stopwatches are important here.
Okie dokie. Well, these items are useful in this game. I always like it when items are useful. That's why I like Dragon Quest, because it's like... One thing I really liked about Dragon Quest 3 from what I played is, you know, just... It does that thing. Random battles actually feel...
Yeah, go down. You can go down. The Oasis should be safe.
Hmm.
You can hit those for lemons and limes. Yeah, and just don't you. And there, the other tree is a lime tree on the right side.
Cool. I guess we'll upgrade Cooper just to keep baby happy.
Hmm?
Yeah. Yeah.
You could have upgraded whoever your little heart desired.
Might as well upgrade Cooper. How many upgrade ranks can they go through?
You get two.
Is there enough for every character in the game? Or do you have to be selective?
No, there's enough for every character in the game. And yeah, that tree right there is a lime tree.
What is Cooper's new ability?
You can look it up in the party member menu. Not the quick party menu, but the party menu. Dizzy shell.
On the ground.
So it can make those thieves dizzy.
Useful. But now he does more damage, so now he's better than Mario.
Yep.
Alright, so...
Yeah, and just keep going. Tasty tonic. You're just gonna... You don't really need tasty tonic. There's not any enemies that I know that shrink you. You're gonna get rid of the lime?
Sorry,
It's okay. It's just hilarious.
Okay, there we go. Now, where do I need to get to?
Try out Cooper's new ability.
Doesn't damage them?
Nope. But it does help with
certain
situations. Well, they all have 4 HP, so you'll be able to probably beat them all in. Yeah, especially since Cooper does 3 hits.
Well, that's actually not gonna help, because no matter what, it's gonna take Mario and Koopa one turn at a time to kill them. So it actually didn't save me a turn. But hey. I made it so only one of them can damage me now.
Well, you're gonna level up anyways. What's the big deal?
I am. I'm about to level up.
Because you're gonna need as much bad points, HP, and FP as you can get for this boss, because he's kind of hard. I had a hard time on this boss. I had a hard time on this boss and the island boss.
Let's see, what do I want now? I'll just put Refund Speedy Spin on until I get something more useful. And I'll just put...
Quake Hammer might be useful against everybody things.
Alright, let's see.
You can try it.
Oh. That is useful.
And now you can just use Power Shell and kill them all.
There we go. That's a useful ability. His only disadvantage is that it only hits ground enemies.
Mm-hmm.
Wish it told me it would hit all enemies. Alright, now where do I need to go? Should I go up more and then head east?
Well, actually, don't. I mean, just keep going that way.
This way?
Yeah, just go all the way west, and you can actually, if you don't want to explore the desert anymore, just go west until you can't go west anymore.
Okay.
And you'll be able to go up north, and you'll be right back at Colorado's camp.
I think I'm right there now. saw a sign or something? No, I was just seeing things.
Are you going desert crazy?
Yeah.
Because if you don't go the linear way with it, you're just gonna get lost.
Can you make me some Dr. Pepper?
Okay, go up. You can go up. It should take you 2 screens.
It's on the counter.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, Tango's on you.
Yeah, so ignore them and just go up 1 more screen and you'll be at Colorado's camp.
Okay.
You have to go back exploring the desert anyway later.
I see. This is the most boring area in the game, isn't it?
No. Well, actually, yes it is. My favorite chapters in this game are chapter 3. The next chapter is my favorite chapter in the game, actually.
Just because it's kind of a lazy area design. It's just.
Kind of.
So, where do I go now? Should I just go east all the way now?
Give me 1 second, baby. This isn't high. Yes, just keep going east all the way. You gotta get to the dry outpost, and that road to Colorado's camp is gonna take you there. Do you want me to walk while you drink? I can do that.
Sure, why don't you do that? Tammy is now in control of the controller.
Yep.
You can zoom there. Coin and another measly battle. Well, use the quake hammer.
I know. I'm playing because I'm hitting all the trees.
I kind of forget to do that. It's not in my instinct to just go up to trees and whack them with the hammer.
Whack, because you don't want to hit them like whack-a-mole.
Mm-hmm. I already feel like crap for doing that.
Yeah, that's the thing about the game that'll make you... When I was younger, it didn't bother me, but when I played it again and I found him, I'm like, oh, I'm sorry, whack-a.
Doesn't even punish you for doing it, but you'll just feel mentally bad.
You mean, yeah.
Your soul, it hurts. Oh. Wow. And now we gotta go to Koopa Village.
Yeah, if you don't want to do the desert part, I definitely don't mind playing that part for you, because I'll explore the whole thing. So since we're here, do you want to go out and get something to eat and then come back?
You know, this is a pretty good stopping place. We've played for a while, so yeah, we'll just stop here for now.
And all probably right. Come back to it today.
Yeah, probably. Alright. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.